When you are in the same category, you are talking about it, you can never talk about it, because number one, you must have the courage from within yourself. Now, Zechariah chapter number 7, verses number 4 and 6, just read that one. Zechariah chapter number 7, verses number 4 and 6, then we finish there write down Moses also, you write 1 Samuel chapter 25 36, to Marizia Apple, because I've gone with a lot of time, I've stretched it because I could not be able to finish this subject, it's too long. Four, let's go, read 1-2, let's go. Five. That's the question God was asking. When you are eating and drinking, you please what? I say you please what? Chakula si ya Mungu, mzee. Chakula ni yako. Chakula ni yako. Wewe ndio mwenye chakula. Wewe ndio mwenye chakula, ukule mwili ndio utembelee hapa duniani utishie watu. Lakini when you are fasting and praying, you are engaging God for anything that may happen in the spiritual to affect the physical. I say anything that may happen, Steve, listen to this. The greatest battle, even what you are undertaking now, it is in the highest level of spiritual realm that it will determine the physical manifestation. That is the biggest battles is not in the physical. You know what? The physical. The biggest battles are fought in the spiritual. And the spiritual, that's why fasting and prayer, it is necessary. Those people miss the Holy Communion last Friday. Don't miss this Holy Communion, because this is the last one we're doing until we do the last one of the Kesha on third. Don't miss those who came. Drango, thank you for coming. Mzendubi was in the hospital. He told me to call him. Kanembe was in the hospital. Those who came. And let me tell you, the experience, those who came, what I was experienced. Prayer is not a, it's not a holiday for anybody. People don't like it. Prayer is hated by all. People want to buy prayers. And that's what the Bible says. And the king said, I have now found a priest who shall pray for me, that I'm not going to pray. A king, he said, I have found a priest. This was a witch, but he said, I have found a priest who can be in my house. Pray for me continuously. So when we are praying, we are not praying to benefit God. We are not praying to benefit what? I said, we are not praying to do what? We are praying to benefit ourselves. To benefit what? I said, we are praying. Now, Deuteronomy chapter number 31, verse 20, as we stand up on our feet. Let's read. Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse number 20. Let's stand on our feet as we are reading that last verse. And then, praise and worship, you do us a few seconds and then we go to the second service. That is what we are doing. We do it until we are satisfied that God is doing something. Somebody said amen. I said somebody said amen.
Chakula. Chakula ni agano mbaya sana ndirangu. Mbaya. Ndio unaona wazee hapa kutani wanakuambia, unataka nikuoneshe mchi? Chinjia wazee nini? Aise chinjia wazee nini? Ni mbuzi hapana? Ni watu wawezi afford mbuzi na nini ndirangu? They can afford. But they want to engage you in the spiritual what? By connect you in the physical realm. Kuchinja hiyo mbuzi unaona kama ni kitu ya kawaida. Ndio Biblia inasema kwamba wakati Barak alishindwa kulaani wana wa Israeli, he prepared a feast, he prepared a celebration, he prepared food. Prepared what? Wakakula vyakula vya idols. After they ate the food of the idols, wakakula wakajaa. Baada kujaa, they had nothing to do. They started committing immorality. And in the same process, the Bible says, and that time when people were praying, it was very hard. So God came down and started fighting them, and that's how they were cast. But initially, when you want to remove somebody's covenant, number one, you must get it. What does the Bible say?
One, two, let's go. When you become fat, the first business. I like that. Number one, they become fat. They become what? Very healthy. Very healthy. Very what? The first enemy when man is back become prosperous. The first enemy is who? Mutu akisha faru, number one. Gladys, you are on women rep. Wanakuru County. Nakuru County. Mahali unavoid number one anywhere. Uzijifanya ati afanya fada mimi ndakuwa na wacha vile muhuri walikuwa wanatuambia ati mimi daika Mercedes ya na bendera ya Kenya hapo nikihubiri crusade Uhuru Park. It's a lie. It's a lie. How many preachers do we have in this country who have joined politics and today we are not seeing them anymore in church? Some of their lunch hours are dead. Morning glory is dead. Every fellowship is dead. Everything is dead. And that's why anybody who's a preacher coming out of the altar calling for politics is a idiot, is a fool, is a devil. God, you can't be a king and a priest at the same time. God will kill you. Saul tried. Go and ask Saul experience yesterday. Do you know a family of Saul perished forever? It was no trace of any single member of his family because of the mistake of his father. How can you do that? Ati oh mimi ndio takwa sababu ati hey nipe wipe ya Yesu hey, bwana asifiwe kwa campaign rally please. Give us a break. Kuwa madhabauni, ufanye kazi, ufunge. Biblia inasemaje? In Leviticus chapter number 6:13. What does the Bible say? You read the Bibles. Nirangu, unasomaga Bible? I remember what? I said, the fire must do what? Ebu Moses weka New King James Version ndio inaweza understand. Hey, this puts it very well. What does it say? Please read it loudly. Sasa nikienda parliament fire itaendelea hapa. Nitakuwa lunch hapa. Niambie ukweli wa Yesu. Hebu sema Kim. Mimi ni MCA Nakuru County. Ile constituency yetu inaitwa nini hapa? Kaptembo passe. MCA Reverend then I did that Reverend Lawrence Weaver MCA useless. Dr. Reverend Lawrence Professor Bulu useless. How are you going to put on the fire? Because Ebu, where is Steve? Where will you tell you wakati wa mioto? Woko kwenu. Na moto is mikan. You said in the house how many days? 30 continuous prosperous strenuous days. 24 times 30. How many hours is that? Yeah? 7? 720. 720. 720 hours, Gladys. Moto wa huyu mwanaume haikuzimika. 720. Angetoka aende keroka ndi arudi badaye. Akuja after 2 days aende kutembelea aunti yake. Angepata nini? Na ikizimika, what is the punishment within your community? Uwezi zaa watoto. Utaanza tena biashara mpya, ununue kondoo, mbuzi nyeusi, nyekundu, ya green, ya panjama, then you sacrifice. Even si wakale wanafanya mclofas, si hata nani alituambia pa Joshua, it is true, fire shall not do what? Ebu, Living Bible inasemaje? Moses inasemaje? Put it Living Bible anafuweka good news to some of you. Remember, you do what? Sasa uko parliament, hebu nikuulize, uko parliament na fire iko. Oh, nitakuwa na wachungaji wataendelea. Please, Levites are different from priests. God called you. Wewe si umesoma Bible? Whatever is accessing the Holy of Holies. Wale walikuwa wanaingia holy of holies
ni mapriest peke yake na anaweka kengere hapa. Ndio unaona walikuwa wanafanyaga, ndio unaona waruja wanafanyaga ile wakiomba waze rishwa. Rishwa. Yaani hii kengere ilikuwa inafanya. Sasa kadhoa anatuletaga ile ya kufanya priest akikunywa kawaika whisky. Kengere ndapiwa ngarangarangaranga. Akikuwa na sakramenti kengere ngarangarangara na tunamuona. But that one you are not seeing because it was deep. Yaani ilikuwa kama pale tena mbele mbele. Sasa ukiendelea akikufa walikuwa nawekaga kwamba hapa mtu aendagi kule kwa Holy of Holies, ndio wanavurutaga kutoka huko, amekufia huko, kama alienda na vurugu zake anavurutiwa hapo, anakuja kuzikwa, na Biblia inasema kwamba watu hawamguzi tena. Sasa madhabahu isifanye nini? Isizimike. Isifanye nini? Isizimike. Hebu turudi hiyo Deuteronomy that 120 tusome hiyo, ndio msome vizuri, tumalize hivyo, atumalize tu, tunaendelea tu, kwani leo ni Jumapili na bado tunaendelea maombi. Next week bado tunaendelea, next Friday tuko hapa Holy Communion, don't miss, tomorrow we are meeting here again. Inasema when I have done what, please read it, please, all of you read it. Number one, let's read it. Weka hiyo New Living Moses, ndio ilikuwa smart kidogo, na huko weka alafu weka Good News pia, eh. The other translation says they will provoke me. They do what? How many people provoke God? Umepata maruti, mzendubi umepata baiskeri. I'm not saying about you, lakini umepata baiskeri. Ati uko busy. Now ni kazi niambia watu ati uko busy, you cannot even get spare 1 hour. Steve Mskero unafanywa Chief Justice wa Kenya, usipokuja na bendera hapa hivi tukuone, tuamini kabisa. Yani ukae kama Justice Gishero. Even Maraga, yeah, Maraga is a big judge in this country, but he never misses his services. Watu wengine wadogo hata wanafagiaga. Hey, mchungaji, niko busy. Niko busy, ne? Niko busy. Dikwira amevutwa, kuna moja amevutwa, alikuwa amekwaza Reverend Teresia Wairimu, and he was a big man in the same. Arabu anaanza kuonesha mchungaji madharau. Uzuri serikali ilimpiga redundancy na ikampiga mpaka ndani. Leo iko ndani analiliaga tu, ako on off, on off. You don't joke with God. When you are prosperous, number one thing you must recognize God. You must do what? Mtu akija tajirikanga unakuwa na kagari, kagari kana unakuja kanisa saa 8:30. Na wale wana gari walikuja saa 1. Hebu niambia, dawa ungekuwa Mungu, brother, what do you do with that kind of people? Wewe ni Mungu, tu assume wewe ni Mungu ndio uko kwa kiti cha enzi. Somebody who has means of transport, he comes to church saa 8:30. Saa hiyo ndio anatoa watoto ndani, wako amepitia last case, wako na pizza, wako na yogurt, wako na soda hili, wako na nini tena wamejipaka. Daddy, tunaingia church, waje nikunywe kidogo. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Oh no. Lift up your hand and say, Lord, deliver me. Please speak to the Lord. Say, my Lord, deliver me. Say, my every spirit of food around my life, every spirit of celebration around my family, say, my every spirit of food that diverting my attention from prayer and fasting, deliver me, Lord. Say, my Lord, deliver me. 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 Say, my every spirit hindering my progress, hindering my spiritual access, I pray, deliver me, Lord. Say, my Lord, deliver me. Say, my Lord, deliver me. Say, my Lord, deliver me. Me and my generation, I pray, nothing shall stop me. Nothing shall stop me from accessing your grace, from accessing your opportunity. I pray, deliver my life. Lift up your hand and say, Lord, deliver me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
deliver my family, deliver my generation. I know my battles are not fought here in the physical, they are fought in the spiritual. I know my family, they are not fought here in the physical, they are fought in the spiritual. I know my ambitions, I know my positions, I know my job and my business, they are fought in the spiritual. Give me the grace that I can access in the spiritual realm. Give me grace I can access. Give me grace I can access. Give me grace, Lord, I can access every hindrance that is hindering me, God, in this prayer and fasting. Give me the grace. I'll come to an end of it. I'll finish it, oh God. It shall be a continuous grace in my life and my children, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every spirit of temptation from every direction, in the name of Jesus Christ, deliver my life, Jehovah. Deliver my family, Jehovah. For every captivity of any food, anything that may hinder me, God, from making progress, deliver my life. I thank you and I bless you in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name.